Hello, students. Good morning. I'm Miss Henderson. Today I am going to be talking to you. I'm going to be presenting to you some calculations on obstetric calculations on pitocin and magnesium sulfate flow rates. So let's look at some of our learning objectives for this lesson. So upon completion of this lecture, student will be able to demonstrate the following competency. Ability to safely calculate magnesium sulfate bolus. Demonstrate competency in calculating flow rates according to doctor's order. Demonstrate the ability to calculate pitocin flow rates. Discuss the indication for pitocin and verbalize the indications for magnesium sulfate. So, the first problem we have here on the board, calculating magnesium sulfate flow rate. So the physician has ordered magnesium sulfate bolus with 4 grams in 100 milliliters of lactated Ringer solution to be given over 20 minutes. What rate should the nurse set the infusion pump? So as you can see, I've set up the equation. We're looking for x mls per hour. So we were giving the volume, we were giving 100 milliliters in 4 grams. And that is to be infused in 20 minutes. So we have 100 milliliters and we have our time 20 minutes. And we know we in flow rate, we're looking for milliliters per hour. So we know one in every hour is equal to 60 minutes. So we are ready to solve this problem. So we have minutes canceling out. And we know that 20 goes into 60 three times, right? We know 20 goes into 60 three times. So we have 3. So then we have 3 times 100 is equal to 300. So we have 300 milliliters per hour. And that's what the nurse is going to program the IV pump to administer. So let's look at some of the indications for magnesium sulfate. What are some of the indications for magnesium sulfate? So some of the indications for magnesium sulfate is that it lowers the blood pressure. It's used to treat preeclampsia, eclampsia, and it also helps to prevent seizure disorder. So we also have some contraindications for magnesium. So these are the contraindications. So patients that have impaired renal function, it's contraindicated to use magnesium sulfate. Patients with heart block or myocardial damage, it's contraindicated. Also, patients with myasthenia gravis cannot use magnesium sulfate. Magnesium sulfate also interacts with nifedipine, so it's also contraindicated. So let's look at pitocin. So what are some of the indications of pitocin? So we know pitocin is a hormone, right? Oxytocin. And it's released by the posterior pituitary gland. So oxytocin is used in obstetric. It helps to increase uterine contraction. It facilitates cervical dilatation. It helps to facilitate vaginal delivery. It increases bonding within the mom and the fetus. It stimulates milk ejection for breastfeeding. It also reduces stress that may contribute to postpartum depression. So those are some indications for oxytocin. So let's look at another problem here. So we have here magnesium fluoride. Magnesium sulfate, 40 gram in 1,000 milliliter of lactated ringer at a rate of 2 grams per hour. What is the pump rate? So what would the nurse set the pump at? So we are looking again for flow rate, which is milliliters per hour. So using dimensional analysis, we are going to set up the equation. So XML per hour equal to, we were giving 1,000 mL of lactated ringers. That's our volume. And with 1,000 mL per hour, and we also, within that 1,000, we have 40 grams. So we have 40 grams here, right? And then the ringer at a rate of 2 grams per hour. So we have every 2 grams in 1 hour. So now we have grams, canceling out with grams. We have 2 goes into 40. We can cancel 0 here. We can cancel another 0 here. And we left with 2 goes into 4 2 times. We have 2 here, and 2 goes into 100. How many times? 50 times. So we have 50 milliliters per hour. That's what the nurse is going to program the IV pump to deliver. So let's look at another problem. So Pitocin flow rate calculation. The physician has ordered 2 milliunits per minute. Pitocin is available with 10 units per ml. Protocol on the LND unit, mix 2 vials per 1,000 ml of normal saline. What should the nurse set the IV pump at? So we know in 1 unit, it's equal to 1,000 milliunits. We also know 60 minutes is equal 1 hour, because that was given to us in the problem. So now we're looking for what? Flow rates, right? So we have 1 unit is in 1,000 milliunits, and we have 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. And it was given to us, the physician has ordered 2 milliunits. So we have 2 milliunits per minute times the volume, the vial, which is 1,000 mL. And protocol states 2 vials of 10 units. So if we have 2 vials of 10 units, which is 20 units, we have 20 units in 1,000 mL. So now we are ready to solve the problem. We have milliunits canceling out. We have minutes canceling out with minutes. We have units canceling out with units. So now we have here 60 times 2 times 1,000 divided by 1,000, or we can even cancel this out. 1,000 into 1,000 is 1. We have also 20 into 60, it's 3. And then we have 3 times 2, which is 6. That gives us 6 milliliters per hour. And that's what the nurse is going to program the pump to deliver. So let's look at another problem, guys. So in this question here, the physician has ordered 500 milliliter of D5W with 10 units of IV oxytocin. Begin at 2 milliunits per minute and then increase by 1 milliunits per every 30 minutes until regular uterine contractions begin. Maximum dose is 30 milliunits per minute. So the first aspect of the problem is asking us what is the IV flow rate for the beginning infusion. So let's solve this. So we're looking for milliliters per hour. So using dimensional analysis, we can set up the equation to solve for XML per hour. So we were giving, the physician has ordered 500 milliliters in 10 units. So we know 500 goes with 10 units. And we know 1 unit is equal to 1,000 milliunits. We were also given beginning infusion at 2 milliunits per a minute. And we know 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So now we are ready to solve this equation. So we have minutes and minutes canceling out. We have milliunits and milliunits canceling out. We have units and unit canceling out. So we have here 500 times 2 times 60, or we can go ahead and cancel. 10 goes into 60 six times, right? We have 500 goes into 1,000. How many times? 2 times. So if you do the calculations, you should have 6 milliliters per hour, which is the beginning infusion rate. Now, the other element to the problem is asking what is the IV flow rate for the maximum infusion? So it's the same concept setting up the equation. We have our milliliters per 10 units, and we were given the maximum dose is 30 milli units. So we have 510 in 10 units, 1 unit is 1,000 milli units, and the maximum dose is 30 milli units per minute, and 1 hour is 60 minutes. So if you do the calculation, the maximum infusion rate should be 90 milliliters per hour. So I wanted to really do this short scream-o-matic to, deepen your understanding of the obstetric calculation for Maths for Med and UR 103. I hope you find this short presentation engaging, and I hope it helps to enhance your knowledge in obstetric calculation. So I have some practice problems in the remainder of the slides, so you can have fun doing those, and I also indicate the answers for most of them. Thank you so much, and see you in the next lecture. Bye for now.